Mr. Dilip Shanghvi is the Managing Director of Sun Pharmaceutical Industries Limited, which has a market capitalization of USD 20 billion and is amongst India's top pharmaceutical companies. Having started small, he focused on eventually growing his company and within years was exporting his products to neighboring countries. Mr. Shanghvi has won numerous awards and accolades, including Forbes Entrepreneur of the Year Award 2014, Economic Times Business Leader of the Year 2014, and CNN IBN's Indian of the Year Business 2011. In 2014, he acquired Ranbaxy, making Sun Pharmaceuticals the largest pharma company in India and the fifth largest specialty generic company globally. The entire IMA team welcomes Mr. Dilip Shanghvi with his charismatic personality to share his views with us.
A leader is known by his talk, and a successful leader is known by the way he walks the talk. Mr. Dilip Shanghvi, a well-established leader, we'll know more about him, ladies and gentlemen, if we hear him about a couple of quotes on his thought processes of life. On winning, he says, "I like to win without fighting, but if I cannot, then I am prepared to fight." That is a never say die attitude. On spotting opportunities, he says, "If a company is not doing well, it doesn't necessarily mean it is not a good company." And this has been the mantra on which he built his empire. On self-evolution, he says, "I have never seen myself as a promoter. I always evaluate myself as a manager. And as manager, I have lot more to learn." And this may be a lot of learning for all of us. Ladies and gentlemen, now I have the honor to read the citation of Mr. Dilip Shanghvi. Mr. Dilip Shanghvi, innovation distinguishes between a leader and a follower, so said Steve Jobs. Padma Shri, Mr. Dilip Shanghvi, founder and managing director of the $22 billion company Sun Pharmaceutical Industries Limited, is well respected for his astute acquisition strategies, joint ventures, and innovative turnaround management. The self-made billionaire who became India's richest man in 2015 and was ranked 8th most powerful person in India by India Today, started the entrepreneurial career in 1982, founding Sun Pharma with just rupees 10,000 and leading it to be an empire of over $22 billion with a massive presence in pharma sector spanning continents. He has been redefining success through his mantra for growth, excellence through innovation, with his talent for turning around his acquisitions and with his never say die attitude. His flagship Sun Pharma is the largest chronic prescription company in India and is also the largest Indian pharma company in USA, as well as the fifth largest globally in its sector. It serves 150 countries with 41 manufacturing facilities across 6 continents with multicultural workforce from over 50 nationalities, a truly Indian multinational. Sun Pharma has been ranked by Forbes amongst the world's most innovative companies. The 2014 acquisition of Ranbaxy Laboratories for USD 4 billion is a big feather in his cap. Very few companies have been able to match or replicate the steady rise and growth of Sun Pharma. Dilip Shanghvi is the recipient of top awards and recognitions, including Padma Shri, IMA Entrepreneur of the Year, NDTV Business Leadership Award, Forbes Entrepreneur of the Year, Economic Times Business Leader of the Year, and many more. He is soft-spoken and a real gentleman whose biggest asset is people management, exhibited in his belief that experts and professionals should manage his business. As a generous philanthropist, his charity, Shantilal Shanghvi Foundation, supports education, healthcare, food for poor, interest-free loans to needy, thus helping tribal and rural children, empowering women and Dalit communities, ably supported by CSR initiatives of Sun Pharma. No wonder he is also fondly called Dilip Bhai by all knowing him well. It is Indore Management Association's privilege and honor to confer the IMA Lifetime Achievement Award for the year 2018 on Mr. Dilip Shanghvi, a truly Indian global business icon.
Thank you. So, good evening to all of you, and I'm very sorry that because my flight got delayed, I was late in coming to the event. So, when Mr. Nayak first called me and suggested that I accept this Lifetime Achievement Award, when I went home and shared this with my family, they were very happy. Happy not for the reason that most of you think that they would be happy, but they were happy because they said that Lifetime Achievement Award is given to people who have retired from business. So I said that if you want to be happy because you've been part of a great journey and you've helped me achieve, I think that's the right reason. If you think that I am retiring, then I think that's a little bit too premature. So I look at the journey of Sun Pharma as a journey that has constantly evolved. The journey which started with two representatives, one of them being me, to where we are today, where we have more than 30,000 people working across different countries on different types of products and businesses. However, there are a few things which have not changed. So when I started the business, I always believed that pharma business is a people business. If you want to do well in this business, your people have to do well. And I always believed that to get the best out of people, you have to achieve a connect with them and appeal to their ability to contribute, not by control, not by supervision, but by making them part of a objective which is bigger than business, making them part of a dream that we have to do something together and we have to achieve something beyond making money. So when I think the citation talked about our financial success, it of course team deserves all the recognition and the credit that we get because of what we've achieved. I think what, to me, what is important is what has gone behind achieving all these successes. Is that if I look at when we started our business in India, we started with psychiatric products. Since last 15 years, we've been number one in terms of share of prescription in psychiatry. And every year, we focus on our growing the share of business and share of prescription from psychiatry constantly. And that's how we evaluate. We don't evaluate our performance in terms of not only the financial terms, but in our ability to maintain the connect with the customers. Over time, I think we've kept on focusing on gaining greater share of prescriptions in different specialties. So we are number one in terms of neurology, we are number one in terms of share of prescription in diabetology, cardiology, in ophthalmology, in more than 13 different therapeutic areas, that we are number one in terms of share of prescription. And to ensure that we maintain this leadership and we continue to grow this share of prescription, we've split our businesses into smaller but autonomous business units where operating managers are empowered to take decision which help their businesses. So the job of the corporate office is to support the business, but the businesses need to constantly find a way to do better than themselves and better than competition in the market. So in the same way, I think our focus on R&D to ensure that we are able to develop products faster, in terms of our manufacturing focus, where we want to focus on finding a way to remain competitive and respond to changes in the market dimensions faster. I think constant focus on trying to do be better than what we were last year, rather than competing with outside companies, I think has helped us achieve what we have become today. People say that we've been very good at acquisition. I think acquisition, we have to be very careful, because every time you do an acquisition, it will help you become bigger. But at the same point of time, it takes away senior management time to manage the acquisition. So you have to be clear that the acquisition justifies itself, because your own business will not grow very well after the acquisition for next 1 to 2 years. So it needs to, so people talk of synergy in acquisition, but we also have to factor the dis-synergy of any acquisition. Fortunately for us, since we are very disciplined about what we want to acquire and how we want to grow our business, most of our acquisitions have been value creative, unlike many acquisitions which are done only for the purpose of becoming bigger. But in global environment where size and your ability to invest in R&D and in your ability to manage what your customer requires by offering a wide and broad product basket, need to grow rapidly to scale and size is a business challenge and a requirement for all Indian companies. Fortunately for us, we were in the business at the right time, at the right place, and we made the right investment. So things have worked out. So when, I hope I'm sharing all of this with you because I believe that all of you have similar challenges and similar opportunities, so that what has helped me in my life and what has helped Sun Pharma become successful can also help you in taking some decisions which will help your businesses. However, while I have been doing, focusing 150% of my time and energy in growing the business, Vibha has been spending 200% of her time in ensuring that we continue to function effectively as a family. So I wish to thank her once again in So she has been both father and mother to both our children, because I have been traveling quite a bit, but she's never felt them realize my absence. So they only find a way to appreciate me for my strength. But in life I have only two compartments. One is family, the other is business. I don't socialize much. I don't attend parties. Since we got married and we had children, we decided that we will not go to any event which we cannot go with our children. So we don't go to parties where alcohol is served. So we've been very disciplined as a family, and I think that has helped us in bringing up the children in a right kind of environment and culture. Touch wood, and fortunately both our children are very grounded, very down to earth, and very practical. So if somebody says that, what is it that I am most proud of, then I think the thing which makes me most proud is when I see my children do things that I find sometimes very difficult to do. So they are not here today, but every time they do well in life, they do well in business. And both of them started their own business at some point of time with a view to learn business. Now they are part of Sun Pharma, but doing very well. And with God's grace and I think blessings of the elder, we continue to function effectively as a family. So thank you very much. I can promise you that this lifetime achievement does not mean that I will stop continuing to make. So this is an interval, but maybe I have a few more years to go. Thank you once again.